A Yule log is a traditional Christmas dessert and is served during Réveillon, the Christmas Eve meal that follows Midnight Mass in France. This rolled sponge cake is supposed to represent a real Yule log, the burning of which was once a popular Christmas ritual. This company uses vanilla or chocolate ice cream instead of frosting. The cake itself is a chocolate-covered sponge cake. Workers start by making chocolate cake batter in a machine called a liquefier. They add flavouring, exactly what, is a trade secret, and liquid eggs, binding agents, butter oil, sugar, flour, and cocoa. After mixing the batter for 20 minutes, a machine called the cake depositor pumps it out into a 50-litre vat. The cake depositor distributes the batter evenly through nozzles spaced 9 centimetres apart. Then it spreads the batter onto brown craft paper that's about a metre wide. The paper's waxed, so the cake won't stick after baking. The machine funnels the batter into an even layer that's 6.5 millimetres thick and 91 centimetres wide. Workers make between 8 and 10,000 Yule logs daily, depending on the size. After baking for 7 minutes at 260 degrees Celsius, a conveyor moves the cake out of the oven at 1.8 meters per minute. Next, a circular saw separates the cake right down the middle. Every 17 seconds, another blade, appropriately called a guillotine, drops down, slicing the cake into smaller segments. A machine pours strawberry jam onto a thick layer of ice cream. This creates 3 layers, including the cake slab underneath. The factory goes through 1,800 kilograms of jam and 12,000 litres of ice cream per 8-hour shift. A worker gently separates the cake slabs, leaving about 8 centimetres of excess ice cream and jam, which is thrown away. She then separates the cake from the craft paper by folding the cake onto itself once, then rolling the cake, ice cream and jam layers together. She doesn't touch the cake, only the paper. She wears rubber gloves to prevent her hands sticking to the paper. The worker rolls the cake into a machine called a slicer. It cuts the cake into 3 20-centimetre long segments, called logs. The slicer deposits the logs into plastic trays. Another machine now decorates them with ice cream. It covers the surface as well as the ends. The ice cream decorations are lace and floral designs. Now for the embellishments. Workers place 2 cherries on each log. Then a machine sprinkles on bits of maple sugar as another worker cuts the connecting ice cream, separating the logs. This factory uses maple sugar bits instead of nuts on its logs out of concern for allergies. Next, a plastic poinsettia on each log. Then a festive greeting is added. A conveyor belt moves the logs through a CO2 tunnel. Inside, sprayers blast the logs with a mist that instantly freezes them. This mist is carbon dioxide refrigerated to minus 85 degrees Celsius. 5 minutes in the tunnel super freezes the outer layer so workers can handle it easily. A wrapping machine covers the logs in clear plastic film. Then another machine simultaneously cuts and heat seals the plastic, enclosing the logs in bags. Finally, a worker packs the bags into boxes for shipping. The factory stores the boxes in its warehouse freezers at minus 35 degrees Celsius.